Hey there, welcome to a video on Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Well, it's like my thoughts on Valhalla. As you can see, I don't have millions of subscribers, so if I make a full-fledged review on a $60 AAA game, no one's gonna listen, so I'm calling it my thoughts. If you, whoever watching this video is here for only bad things or only good things about Valhalla, then it's not for you, cause it's going to have both positives and negatives about this game. And this video is part 1 of a 3-part series, and this part is spoiler free, and the next 2 parts will have spoilers. They will be coming in future. So if you are watching this video now, you have to wait, and if you are like watching this way long after I uploaded, you can find the full playlist in the description. And without further delay, let's get into it. By the way, if you are triggered by how I said Valhalla, sorry, man, come on. I don't know, I have heard people saying Valhalla, 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 Valhalla. There are many ways like people have said, and even in the game, they said so many different ways. So I don't know what is a real way. So this is not like I'm trying to be racist or something, but this is like I'm trying my best to say the word. So if you were triggered, sorry, come on. You have to bear this. To be honest, Valhalla is not a bad game, but it's not the best game the world has ever seen. Well, if you are an Assassin's Creed fan and have played and enjoyed the other games except Odyssey, this game is definitely for you, cause this game does good fan service and connects the AC lore with the mess of a lore Odyssey created, and sets up the future of this franchise. But to be honest, if this game was like released in the early days, I would have been happy, because the next game would have potential. But based on Ubisoft's track record, I can say the next game is going to ruin this franchise once more. But so far I can say this game is better, at least as of now, the lore makes sense. And if you have played the first few games and are the biggest fanboys of our Ezio and feel like Assassin's Creed without Ezio is like Earth without water, well, I'm glad to say you are definitely gonna hate this game. And if you are someone who got into this franchise during the Odyssey or Origins, I mean the RPG-esque times, then you are definitely going to like this game, because this game is completely same as those two, if not better. So this is the perspective being an Assassin's Creed fan. But now for a general gamer who plays game not based on what franchise it belongs to and enjoys the game for what it is, I have to say the game is not that bad and not that good, but it is the perfect balance between worst and the best. I mean, the main character Eivor is charismatic enough to make the story engaging, but some of the repetitive tasks makes it uninteresting. The good graphics and solid 60 FPS is amazing. But the freaking bugs every now and then makes it weird. Less grindy than Odyssey, but it has a messy skill tree. These are like some of the examples of good and bad things. So you can buy this game. I can't say it's a waste of money. If you don't buy this game now, definitely you can wait for it to be on sale, cause you'll like it. Though Return of Sorcerer's Stealth and Parker environment is good, but stealth is not what you have to do. It's like, it's there, and if you don't wanna do it, you don't have to stealth. And you can ignore this stealth mechanics. Previously, Assassin's Creed would force you to do stealth missions, which I somehow hated, but now I feel like they should be back. Now, if you play a game from Assassin's Creed, how would you know it is an Assassin's Creed game and not some other game, not some other Ubisoft games? Well, first thing should be a good main character, some good side characters, a nice setting, good Parker mechanics, some captivating background scores, beautiful sceneries while synchronizing from towers, engaging story, and most importantly, the conflict between the Assassins and the Templars, and how did they affect or set the history we read in the books? I'm glad to say that Valhalla handles these things in sort of a good way. And Ava for sure is better than Connor, Cassandra, Arno, and Jacob. And the modern day finally gets screen time to do something to the plot. Unlike the drab modern day introducing Black Flag after the Desmond saga. This is the first time the modern day has some impact and explores and expands the lore quite a bit. Now, you may say that the modern day brought back by Origins, but it was not expanded. It was like, yes, Leila Hassan is the new protagonist, and in the next game, Odyssey, she was like, she meets, I don't know what to say about that game. And in this game, Leila does something which makes her likable. Well, maybe not as great like Desmond Miles, but she is definitely a good character. As a fan of the franchise and seeing Ubisoft's track record for the last few years, I can say that I didn't have any expectations and didn't pre-order this game. But after seeing some YouTube videos, I thought I should give it a try. And finally, after playing it for myself, I found this is quite amazing. Not the best games by any means, but surely better than some other AC games. If you still haven't bought the game and searching review to decide about buying and come across this video, then I can say you that you can wait for a price drop. But if you don't have a PS5 or Xbox Series X or any other game to play right now, then you should go for it because it's not gonna disappoint you. Valhalla at the end of the day is another Ubisoft open world game with some of the negative qualities of the other games as well as some of the better qualities of Assassin's Creed, like Chaucer's Death is finally back, which was discarded in Origins for story purposes, and Odyssey was not even an Assassin's Creed game, so leap of faith in that game would also make no sense. And attention to details they had, Ava couldn't do leap of faith in the first few hours. We have to learn it from one of the assassins, like either from Basim or Haytham, which is a good thing. It's like, this is the problem which people had with Black Flag, because Ava wasn't an assassin, but how could he do leap of faith? He was just a pirate. So finally, if I'm not wrong, the developers of this game were also the developer of Black Flag, so they finally listened to the fans, which is a good thing. One more thing they had like Black Flag is the sea shanties. Well, you have to collect those sea shanties using some parkour course in that game, but in this game it's like you have to collect some tatao. Well, you have to collect some tattoos, which is a good thing. It forces you into doing that. It's like very much an Assassin's Creed game. While playing Assassin's Creed 2, 3, Brotherhood, Black Flag, those games, I hated some of the things from Assassin's Creed, but then after playing Origins and Odyssey, I missed like the training missions from Black Flag. I used to hate them, but while playing the modern games, like the recent last two games, I missed those because because those make me feel like an assassin. And then some things like from Brotherhood and 2, and it was also in Black Flag or something, it was like they forces you to be stealthy, and if you are seen by even just one guy, mission fails, which I hated back in the time, but now I liked so much because I miss that, because it was like they forces you to do stealth, but this game never forces you to do stealth or parkour. You can play like a normal Assassin's Creed, and you can also play like a normal Viking game. Anyway, I think this video is getting longer, so I will end it here, and in the next part I will talk a bit more about the story details, and I will talk about some of the mythical things which I like and dislike, which I for some reason forgot to mention in this video. Sorry for that. Stay tuned.